Humans have been on the planet for approximately 300,000 years. During those years, we have witnessed and survived tragedies such as wars, nuclear explosions, mass starvation, and fatal outbreaks. But what if we were here much earlier? What if we lived on Earth 200 million years ago, when most present problems to mankind did not exist yet? But there was something worse than nuclear bombings, wars, famine, and incurable diseases during that time period. And that was having to coexist with dinosaurs. What would we do if we existed back then in a world filled with gigantic lizards? Could humanity have survived even a single day on Earth during the Jurassic period? Today, we'll talk about it from a scientific standpoint. It will be a new discovery. Are you ready? Let's get this started. If modern humans were sent back in time to the Jurassic period through teleportation and time travel, they would find it difficult to know or recognize the Earth. Everything would appear different from what we know about Earth today during the Jurassic period, even the position of the continents as we know them now. During that period, Pangaea was just beginning to divide into two, which changed the environment and allowed the planet's population to flourish. Of course, it's worth noting that dinosaurs were the most numbered species on the planet throughout the Jurassic period. In fact, it was only their extinction that allowed mammals to advance, eventually leading to the appearance of humans. However, if humans were present at the time, their primary concern would be to avoid being eaten, especially by the Tyrannosaurus Rex. This dinosaur could run up to 72 kilometers per hour, or about 45 miles per hour, while weighing 14 tons. Aside from these, there were also smaller and quicker dinosaurs that hunted in packs, and for that reason, it would have been easy for them to hunt down any human being. They had the speed, binocular eyesight, acute sense of smell, night vision, and killer instincts. And according to American paleontologist and evolutionary biologist Stefan Brossat from the University of Edinburgh, a person would have to do much to avoid death given these traits. However, predatory dinosaurs would not have been the sole danger for humans. Herbivores must also be avoided. In fact, they are more dangerous than predators, for they might attack you with their barbed tails or impale you with their horns. You might have even been trampled to death if you hadn't noticed Diplodocus, which is the size of four elephants put together. Hunting such large animals would also be extremely tough. Even now, scientists are not sure how robust dinosaur skin is. This implies that it is unknown if it can be destroyed by a knife, a spear, or even a bullet. Even if you were successful in killing a dinosaur, the smell would attract predators and scavengers. If you lingered for a long time with a large piece of raw meat, you were almost certainly smelled by other dinosaurs and eaten. Aside from dinosaurs, the oxygen level of the atmosphere was fairly low during the Jurassic period, around 15%, which would be a huge problem in and of itself. Hypoxia, or oxygen deprivation, was most likely to be the cause of health concerns during the dinosaur era. This can lead to altitude sickness, which causes continual shortness of breath, spatial disorientation, unconsciousness, and in extreme cases, death. But suppose we've managed to survive it. What about water sources during this period? Because the human body isn't adapted to the Jurassic period's bacteria and microbes, a sip of water from any reservoir could be fatal. Although drinking water is now filtered in multiple stages, the risk remains. What can we say about the Jurassic period if no water filtration system existed? Getting a germ or possibly progenitor of malaria from an ancient honeydew is a real possibility. The dinosaurs themselves most likely contained huge flat and roundworms, as well as millions of other parasites that infiltrated the organisms of prehistoric reptiles from the inside out. Not to mention the many insects and snakes that lurked around. One incorrect touch or bite could endanger your life. For instance, consider the web of the enormous spider Nephilia jurassica. Scientists are unsure whether it was dangerous, but it did weave a 1.5 meter or 5 foot strand of extremely durable golden thread. It's possible that little dinosaurs got stuck in it. Now let's move on to what people might have been eating 200 million years ago. eggs were one of the best options for satisfying hunger, especially those massive lizard eggs rich in protein. Unfortunately, other species would require the eggs as well. Many other dinosaurs enjoy ravaging clutches for food. You would have to grab it quickly if you wanted to keep ahead of your rivals and avoid being attacked by the giant mother. If you weren't successful in stealing eggs, you could go fishing instead. Many portions of the existing land were submerged during the Jurassic period. It's just that numerous species dwell in the shallows of warm water, like the unique plankton that has the ability to tint the water red. That suggests you could have caught a snail if the blood color hadn't terrified you. However, fishing would be risky for humans because the seas and oceans of the time were inhabited by dangerous creatures. For example, the Leopleurodon's teeth were roughly 7 centimeters or around 2.7 inches long. If you happened to cross paths with it and you hadn't escaped in time, you might have become food for this creature. It would also be a major difficulty if you were a vegan during the Jurassic period. Many diverse plants flourished on the ground during the period, but it's difficult to tell if it's a flower, berry, or fruit. There was something that looked like the fruit of modern ginkgo, but you couldn't eat it because of the awful smell of excrement. Furthermore, fungus and seaweed were abundant during the Jurassic period, but none of the species were comparable to what humans eat today. This does not imply that they were all deadly, but you would only have one way to figure it out: by tasting them. In some situations, it could be a success, and in others, it could result in food poisoning, or at worst, a horrible death. If only one human had been alive during the Jurassic period, he or she would have definitely died. Statistically speaking, it would have most likely happened within a couple of days. On the other hand, if there were a large enough population of humans, they could manage to adapt and survive. The usage of metal, on the other hand, wasn't very important. Even if you brought it with you from modern times via your teleportation, it would immediately rust due to excessive humidity during the period. Moreover, it would be hard for humans to do anything during this period since working in low oxygen environments is way too difficult. Even if humans were able to adapt to their surroundings, they would not be able to coexist peacefully with dinosaurs. According to biologist and paleontologist Victoria Arbour of the Royal Ontario Museum, based on our existing relationship with the great predators, such as lions, wolves, and bears, people and predators would not get along very well. For example, for us to be able to secure ourselves, loved ones, and properties from wolves, humans nearly wiped off the animal's entire population in North America. However, there is still no study testifying if humans could do that with a predator that is 70 times the size of a wolf. Despite the threat and dangers of these ancient animals, scientists have been conducting studies to recreate them. Harvard University researchers led by biologist George Church are attempting to implant mammoth genes retrieved from ancient DNA into the present genome of the Asian elephant. If they are successful in doing this, these enormous woolly beasts may appear again on Earth within a few decades. Other than that, scientists are also attempting to restore dinosaurs. However, the problem here is that dinosaurs have been long gone, and so obtaining their DNA requires considerable effort. From a different perspective, dinosaurs still coexist with us, since crocodiles, birds, and turtles are all descendants of prehistoric lizards that evolved and survived to the current day. All of the information I've presented today is only true based on what we know about these species now. Perhaps scientists will discover new facts that will entirely transform our understanding of the Jurassic period in the future. But that's the beautiful thing about science. We have the opportunity to always seek the truth and learn something new about our surroundings. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching Ponder This.